Up until a few years ago, Google didn't make Pixel phones. It made Nexus phones. Despite the periodic road bumps, such as the bootlooping 5X, generally the brand was much loved by the Android community. And when Google axed it for their more general, consumer-focused Pixel brand, many Android enthusiasts were disappointed. The Nexus name had usually represented a lower-cost handset with a high-quality Android experience, and the new Pixel line was more targeted to compete with the other expensive flagships on the market. And while there were other devices from companies like OnePlus that offered fantastic features at a relatively low price tag, they still weren't direct from Google phones. Software updates still weren't as fast as Google's, and said software was not completely stock Android. But then a few months ago, the rumor mill started spinning and leaks of a Pixel 3a and 3a XL began to crop up. Supposedly, this would be a way to get the incredible Pixel 3's camera for a whole lot less cash. And at Google I.O., the rumors and leaks were all confirmed. Google launched these two devices as lower-cost options in the previously pricey Pixel lineup. And suddenly we realized, could this be a kind of return of the Nexus line, albeit under a different name? The Nexus line was a simple, affordable way to get a relatively high-quality Android experience. It's important to remember that during the reign of the Nexus, fantastic, budget-friendly Android options really were nowhere to be found. Brands like OnePlus were only just getting started. For a respectable price, you got a fantastic Android phone with decent specs. However, things were not all sunshine and rainbows with the Nexus line. Bad battery life was often quite an issue. Additionally, Nexus devices were never at the top of the heap when it came to camera performance. You weren't going to buy a Nexus if you wanted the best smartphone camera available, that was for sure. Finally, random bugs and issues often seemed to plague the Nexus phones, whether it was the battery defect of the Nexus 6P that led to a lawsuit, or even the bootlooping 5Xs, the last of the Nexus line. The experience certainly wasn't perfect. Despite all these issues, the Nexus brand was held quite dearly in Android enthusiasts' hearts. When Google ended it with the launch of the more premium, more expensive Pixel phones, these enthusiasts were understandably disappointed. The first Pixels were around twice the price of the Nexuses they succeeded. But now that's changing. The Pixel 3a and 3a XL are drawing a lot of comparisons to the Nexus phones of old. In fact, they may be even better than the Nexus phones ever were. Today, Google has their own highly capable hardware division. With Nexus, Google outsourced the design and manufacturing to their OEM partners. Now, Google has an in-house team that is able to design and build smartphones to their own specifications. Unlike some of the later Nexus phones, the 3As don't ship with Qualcomm's most powerful processors. However, the devices feel perfectly fast for normal use. A quick tweak to the animation speed in developer options, and unless you're using it side by side, it didn't feel noticeably slower than the more expensive Pixel 3, at least in my experience. Even battery life, while not necessarily outstanding, is still considerably better than the Nexuses ever were. The 3a XL is often getting around 5 hours of screen on time, which is certainly respectable. But the standout feature of the Pixel 3a is the camera. The camera is utterly amazing. It is, for all intents and purposes, the full Pixel 3 camera in a much cheaper phone. As mentioned previously, the Nexuses were never great in the camera department. This is such an incredible shift for budget phones. No longer do you have to put up with a less than ideal camera experience to save a few bucks. The Pixel 3a gives you what some may call the best camera in a smartphone today. In many ways, the Pixel 3a is what the Nexus phones always should have been. It's just taken Google a bit of time to figure it out. Let's hope that they continue this budget version of their Pixel flagships going forward. Well, that's it for this video. If you enjoyed this video, definitely give it a thumbs up, as that helps a lot. If you'd like to see more videos like this, feel free to subscribe to the Android Police channel. If you'd like to subscribe to my personal channel as well, feel free to click on my face here. My name is Jackson Hayes, and this is Android Police.